Hello, my dear student. I'm Samprita from Economics Department. Welcome back to online class. This is a continued part of Module 2, Theory of Consumer Behavior. Discuss about indifference curve in this class. This indifference curve developed by economists like F.Y. Edgeworth, Wilfredo Pareto, and J.R. Hicks. What is the meaning of indifference curve? Indifference curve is a graphical representation of various alternative combination of bundles of two goods among the consumer is indifference. And an indifference curve may be defined as a curve which shows a number of alternative combination of two or more goods which yield the same total level of satisfaction. That means two or more good which yield a same level of satisfaction. Consumer consume two or more goods which rank the satisfaction, which rank the utility. Alternatively, indifference curve is a locus of point that shows two combination of commodity which give same level of satisfaction. As you know, utility cannot be measured in terms of numbers, so it is experienced and compared. That means the utility can be experienced by the consumer and compared which commodity give more satisfaction and which commodity give less satisfaction. Let us assume that I will give one of the example. A consumer, if a person going to buy a fruit, mango and orange, he like mango, so he prefer firstly mango because the mango gives a greater utility than a orange. So, a utility is experienced by the consumer. That's why he prefer firstly mango. And every consumer possesses a definite scale of preference for a goods and services. The consumer have a scale of preference which commodity he should choose first. And scale of preference reveal the order of preference of a consumer. This scale of preference reveals that the order of preference by the consumer. It dispense with the measurement of utility. For example, a consumer has to make a choice among the apple, mango, banana and orange. He gives them different rank according to his order of scale of preference. On this time, he gives first place to banana. It is understood that the banana give greater utility than other fruits, than other apple, orange and mangoes. So this is a scale of preference. Let us come to know about assumption of indifference curve. Every rational consumer has definite scale of preference. I already said that a scale of preference, every rational consumer have different scale of preference, like which commodity he should choose first. And perfect knowledge about price and the market. He have the perfect knowledge about a price of the commodity available in the market and the market structure. A rational consumer and he tries to maximize his utility. There should be a rational consumer and he should maximize his utility. Right? He should maximize his utility. And the price of the different goods and services are given. I already said a price of the different good should be given, and this knowledge will be given to the consumer. Income of the consumer is constant. Here, the income of the consumer should not vary time to time. It should be constant, and he must use entire his income to the consumption of goods or buying of goods and services. Ordinal measurement of utility. In earlier class, I have given the meaning of ordinal utility and cardinal utility. So, in this theory, there is ordinal measurement of utility. In this schedule, 5 different combination of banana and apple is given. Combinations are P, Q, R, S, T. It give same level of satisfaction. So, the consumer is indifferent as to whether he get combination of P, that one apple and 15 banana, or the combination at Q, 2 apple and 10 banana, or the combination of T, 5 apple and 1 banana. When the quantity of apple is increasing, then he decrease his quantity, he preferred banana will decrease. Thus, all the combination will give a same level of satisfaction. And this indifferent schedule can be explained through indifference map or indifference curve. It is a geometrical device represent different combination of two goods yielding same level or equal level of satisfaction. To form an indifference curve, the data is available here, available in the indifference schedule, should be plotted on the graph. That means the OX axis shows apple, quantity of apple he preferred, and OY axis shows the quantity of banana he preferred. When he preferred one apple and 15 banana, on the P point, he preferred one apple and 15 banana. On the point of Q, he preferred the quantity of apple increased and quantity of banana decreased. So, he preferred 2 apple and 10 banana. On the point of R, he preferred 3 apple and 6 banana. On the point of S, he preferred 4 apple and 3 banana. In this, here, whenever he consumes more and more apple, he decreases his quantity of preference of banana. So, IC1 is a indifference curve. A P, Q, R, S, T is a different combination. All these combinations are giving equal satisfaction to the consumer. The consumer is different to this combination as he will neither better off or worse off in choosing or any of this combination. Hence, indifference curve is known as iso-utility curve or equal satisfaction curve. An indifference curve is always downward sloping left to right. The principle of diminishing marginal rate of substitution is responsible for negative slope of indifference. So, indifference map refers to a family of indifference curve, that represent consumer preference over all the bundles of two goods. And indifference curve represent all the combination which provide same level of satisfaction. However, every higher or the lower satisfaction can be shown on difference indifference curve. It means infinite number of indifference curve can be drawn. It will shown in the diagram. In this figure, IC1 represent a lowest satisfaction and IC curve 2 shows a satisfaction more than the IC1 curve, and the highest level of satisfaction is depicted by indifference curve, IC3 curve. However, each indifference curve shows the same level of satisfaction individually. It must be noted that higher indifference curve represent higher level of satisfaction and lower indifference curve shows lower level of satisfaction that represent larger bundle of good, which means more utility because of monotonic preference. Monotonic preference means every consumer prefer which give a bundle of large amount of quantity of good which give same level of satisfaction. So this is mean that monotonic preference. Let us know the meaning of marginal rate of substitution. An indifference curve is based on the principles of diminishing marginal rate of substitution. The marginal rate of substitution refers to the rate of exchanging one commodity for another on the marginal basis. The aim of substitution is maintaining the same aggregate level of satisfaction as before. Because of marginal rate of substitution, the indifference curve slopes downwards. The marginal rate of substitution is a rate of relative change between the two goods. So here, marginal rate of substitution apple and B is equal to units of banana willing to sacrifice for divided by units of apple willing to gain. It is a formula for marginal rate of substitution. It must be noted that mathematical term marginal rate of substitution should always be negative, as numerator will be always have negative value. However, for analysis, absolute value of marginal rate of substitution is always considered. In this schedule, it seems in the given schedule and the diagram. When a consumer moves to P to Q, he sacrifices 5 banana and gain 1 apple. Thus, MRS AB comes out of 5:1. From Q to R, he sacrifices 4 banana and gain 1 apple. Marginal rate of substitution A for B is 4:1. In combination T, the sacrifice falls to 2 banana for 1 apple. In other words, the marginal rate of apple for banana is diminishing. It is shown in the figure also. At the point of P, he sacrifices 5 banana and gain 1 apple. In the point of Q, the sacrificing of 5 banana and gain of 1 apple. In the point of R, he sacrifices 4 banana and gain another apple, one more apple. This is shown in the figure. Why marginal rate of substitution diminishing? The marginal rate of substitution fall because of law of diminishing marginal utility, as you already studied about law of diminishing marginal utility. In the given example of apple and bananas, combination P has only 1 apple, and therefore apple is relatively more important than a banana. Due to this, a consumer is willing to give up more banana for addition of apple. But as he consumes more and more of apple, his marginal utility from apple keeps on diminishing. This is based on law of diminishing marginal utility. As consumer consumes more and more of one good, his marginal utility diminishes. As a result, he is willing to give up less and less of banana for each apple. This is called as marginal rate of substitution. Let us come to know about properties of indifference curve. There is so many properties of indifference curve. Let us discuss about one by one. Indifference curve always convex to the origin. Convex means this shape. An indifference curve is convex to the origin because of marginal rate of substitution. The MRS declines continuously because of law of diminishing marginal utility, as seen in the table. When the consumer consumes more and more of X commodity, his marginal utility from X keep on diminishing, right? He is willing to give up less and less for Y for each apple. Therefore, indifference curve are convex to the origin. It must be noted that MRS indicates the slope of indifference curve. And second property is indifference curve slopes downwards. It implies that the consumer consumes more of one good, he must consume less of another good. It happens because if a consumer decides to have more unit of one good, that is apple or a commodity X, he will have to reduce a number of commodity or number of unit another good, that is commodity Y or commodity banana. So the total utility remains the same. In order to remain on the same level of satisfaction, consumer must sacrifice one commodity for another. Here he sacrifices for X commodity, he sacrifices commodity Y for gain X commodity, right? So that's why indifference curve slopes downwards. And indifference curve never intersect with each other. That means indifference curve never intersect with 1 and 2. Indifference curve 1 never touches with or intersect with indifference curve 2. As two indifference curve cannot represent a same level of satisfaction, they cannot intersect each other. It means only one indifference curve will pass through a given point on a indifference map. In the following diagram, satisfaction from the point A from B on IC1 will be the same. Similarly, A and C on IC2 are also give the same level of satisfaction. It means point B and C should all also give a same level of satisfaction. However, this is not possible as B and C lie on the two indifference curve, that is IC1 and IC2 respectively, and represent different level of satisfaction. Therefore, two indifference curve cannot intersect with each level, that is a point A. And another property is higher indifference curve represent higher level of satisfaction, lower indifference curve shows represent lower level of satisfaction. In this diagram, IC1 curve and IC2 curve are there. The IC2 curve give a higher level of satisfaction and IC1 curve give lower level of satisfaction. So that's why the fourth property of indifference curve is that higher indifference curve always represent higher level of satisfaction than the lower indifference curve. In other words, the combination which lies on higher indifference curve will be preferred to the combination which lie on a lower indifference curve. Consider indifference curve IC1 and IC2 in the above figure. Here, IC2 gives a higher satisfaction than the IC1. Okay. And next property is indifference curve do not touch either axis. Either axis, that is here either y axis, either x axis. An indifference curve represents various combination of two commodities. If an indifference curve touches horizontal axis or the vertical axis, it implies that a consumer prefers only one commodity because when it touches axis, on one of the commodity becomes zero quantity. This violates a basic definition of an indifference curve. We already studied about definition or the meaning of indifference curve. Consumer prefer two commodity which give a same level of satisfaction. When a indifference curve touches either y-axis or x-axis, it represents, or it means that he consumes only commodity X or only commodity Y. It violates the basic definition of indifference curve. Hence, an indifference curve never touches with the either x-axis or y-axis. An indifference curve need not to be parallel to the each other. So, indifference curve need not to be the parallel to the each other because they are based on the cardinal measurement of utility, and the rate of substitution need not to be the same in all the indifference curve. It may be like IC1 curve here and IC2 curve here and IC4 curve here. There is no definite proportion between a range of different level of satisfaction represented by different indifference curve. Indifference curve can be drawn in the manner, but they should be sloping downwards, left to right, convex to the origin, and never intersect with each other. So these are the properties of indifference curve. So here we completed a discussion regarding indifference curve. What is the meaning of indifference curve, the assumption of indifference curve, and some of the properties of indifference curve. Thank you.